This is a forest. So is this. And this. Yep, also a forest. This too. Well, you get the point. Different kinds of forests exist all around the world. Altogether, the world's forests are home to about 50% of all known species. They provide medicine, food, and fuel to a huge fraction of humanity. You've probably heard of photosynthesis before. It's a process where plants convert sunlight, carbon dioxide, and water into chemical energy. Trees absorb carbon from the atmosphere to create their leaves, trunks, and limbs, and then they release oxygen back into the air that we breathe. But what about climate change? Trees need carbon dioxide to photosynthesize, but high levels of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases are also causing more frequent droughts and more severe storms. What does this mean for forests? And how do we even answer big questions like this? This is where ForestGEO comes in. ForestGEO is a global network of scientists and large-scale, long-term forest research sites, encompassing tropical, temperate, and boreal forests. That is, types of forests with characteristics that vary by latitude. Altogether, our network has censused over 7 million trees, spanning more than 12,000 species. That's about 20% of the world's known tree diversity. Especially when we consider the urgency of climate change, we know that forests are critically important because they store about half of the world's carbon. Do you think that all trees store the same amount of carbon? In 2018, ForestGEO scientists came together to write a paper called Global Importance of Large Diameter Trees. Writing a paper is the way that scientists communicate their findings to each other. In this paper, they used data from 48 ForestGEO sites spanning a diversity of ecosystems. They found that large diameter trees consistently play an outsized role in storing carbon. Averaged across those sites, the largest 1% of trees were responsible for 50% of above-ground live biomass. Let's take a closer look at what this means. Above-ground biomass is a scientific term that refers to the amount of matter that a tree has in its trunk, branches, and leaves. Imagine a forest with 100 trees. Some trees are old and very big. Some are light limited and don't grow very large. Many are very young and small. What if we could take the above ground biomass of the entire forest and put it on one side of a balance? The balance would definitely tip, but what if we moved the single largest tree to the other side? Well, the balance would balance. This study demonstrated that a very few large diameter trees can have a huge impact on an ecosystem. But how does this relate to our big question about climate change? Biomass can be an estimate for how much carbon a tree is storing. In the ForestGEO study, the largest 1% of trees were responsible for 50% of all above-ground biomass. As such, we can infer that the largest 1% of trees were responsible for storing about half of all carbon in the forests. That's huge! Other ForestGEO research demonstrates that small trees play important roles in forest health, but this study shows that conserving large diameter trees is a strategic way to preserve forests' ability to store carbon and mitigate climate change. These discoveries are possible because of ForestGEO's vast network of forests and researchers. When we have big questions, we need lots of data to inform our answers. But having lots of data alone isn't enough. In order to compare data from different sites, we need to use standardized methodologies. And we do. All of the collaborators in our network measure trees in precisely the same way. Field crews conduct censuses at our forest research sites in regular intervals, usually every 5 years. They use the same techniques to map, measure, tag, and identify to species all stems with a diameter greater than or equal to 1 centimeter. That's about all trees that are thicker than your thumb. And field teams do this for every tree in the entire forest research site. A durable metal tag is attached to each and every stem. That tag helps scientists track how much a tree grows over time. The sizes of our research sites vary, but most are greater than 20 hectares. That's nearly as big as 50 football fields. How forests respond to climate change will have profound consequences for life on Earth. It's a big question, and one that ForestGEO, with its standardized way of tagging, mapping, and measuring trees, all around the world, is well positioned to answer. ForestGEO is a cross-unit initiative of the Smithsonian Institution, administered by the Smithsonian Tropical Research Institute in Panama. We hope that you'll visit us online to explore global forests, learn about our latest research, and meet the communities and scientists who make this work possible.